Charlie, guess where we're going? Well, to the Creation Museum in Kentucky.
Guys, muffin or biscuit? Because we're gonna see if they have any more. You got muffins or biscuits? Thank you. She didn't like that.
Lunch break?
He's eating tomato, isn't he?
He's eating hummus.
And a napkin.
Oh. Hummus and a napkin.
Shoes off. So we just got to our Airbnb, right? Petersburg, Kentucky.
Checkers.
I know, it's such a nice little place. Hey, as soon as you get inside, take your shoes off, okay? No shoes on the carpet. Take your shoes off, girl.
Ooh, we have Netflix.
What's this?
Get your shoes. Put them on the bench, okay? Are you guys looking around?
Mommy, the fridge has mustard in it.
The fridge has mustard in it. Henry found the bathroom. Mustard, yeah. This is such an adorable place.
Ew, a clock.
Red pepper flakes.
And there's more too. There's a lot more.
Playing with ketchup as our cheese. Okay. Okay, this is mislabeled. So this is Uncle Drew's. Uncle Drew highly recommended this. Baby J, this is you, girl.
I thought that's mine.
No, this is Baby J.
Oh,
God. A nice little cute
Daddy,
pop-up.
I don't want lemonade tonight.
Wait,
I want a burger.
This is you.
What's me?
You?
Oh my word, all of that cheese?
This one's mine. I got way more cheese than everybody.
You did?
It looks like confetti.
Hey, do you want some cheese?
No, it
literally
looks like confetti.
Mm.
Oh, that's
one. Oh my gosh.
So, we'll start this again tomorrow, and we'll get back to it. So, it looks like Joel has 8 questions right. Brody's in the lead with 10 questions. And
I've got something.
Who is this? Henry? 8 questions, and I'm right behind him. Brody. Brody's kicking our butts, guys. Good job, Brody.
What kind of game is that again?
Pictionary, Star Wars. And Brody's killing us.
Brody's Yoda.
Tiny but mighty.
I want Fruit Leathers.
Do you want some hot cocoa? Fruit Leathers.
No fruit. Fruit Leathers.
Oh, with marshmallows.
White Fruit Leathers.
Like a church. Oh, they're here with breakfast. So that was them dropping off breakfast. They were in and out like super quick. Just wanted to scoot in, put it on the table, and scoot back out. But they were really, really sweet. Okay, so we've got bananas. We've got sausage links, banana, nut loaf, orange juice. Yeah. And hash brown casserole, a sweet little note. Everything in this adorable basket, and then you just put it back. All the stuff back later. I know. And then they'll come back and pick everything up later in the day. But are you ready for your hot cocoa?
Yeah.
All right, come on. Sure, he'll be fine.
This side is gonna
But that you said the bed is super comfortable.
Yeah.
You ready for your hot cocoa? Walk on that bridge, okay?
Oh,
It does. Look how pretty all that is. Get down, Henry. Get down.
About that garden. It meant that for billions of years, animals lived, suffered, and died. If all of this happened long before Adam and Eve, then how could God view his creation as very good? For years, I struggled to fit billions of years into my beliefs about creation, but it never satisfied me. I mean, if God made a world full of death and disease, what would that say about his character? That he likes suffering and death? Recently, I began to realize those millions and billions of years had clouded my understanding. The Bible tells how God created a perfect world, just like I learned in Sunday school, but when Adam and Eve sinned against God by eating the forbidden fruit, that rebellion brought so much tragedy into the world. God's beautiful, very good creation had been corrupted. But if those horrible events were already part of the world for millions of years, there's no turning brokenness back.
Don't climb it, okay?
The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had created. And the Lord God brought every beast of the field and every bird of the air to Adam, to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature,
look, keep off the grass.
That was the name thereof.
See that?
The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had created. And the Lord God was with him, and he said, "Every bird of the air,
those who
are the people, and they were both with him, Adam and his wife."
Ah, one of my favorites. Green herb for food.
And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he took one of his ribs and laid it into a woman, and brought her to the man. And Adam said, "She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man." And they were
look, there they are.
The man
is Adam and Eve.
And his wife, and were not
ashamed.
There.
Killed his brother Abel. Through the line of Cain came industry, metalworking, music, art. But along the way, they forgot all about God and just chose to live their own way. Years ago, God spoke to my grandson.
What's he doing? He's working on the ark.
You need to have a look at that new ship of the flanks. Bitch.
Thank you.
like all the storage compartments and stuff.
Yeah.
For all their children, little pigs.
It's all locked. Were those pigs checked by Chevy Boys of them on?
Judgment is coming, my friend. But if you
marry Baby Jack,
save the Ark.
No dinosaur.
Where?
Why stay with us?
Oh, yeah, way over there.
I know, I saw them.
What about those long necks? Mm-hmm. Baby seeds.
Well, there's three T-Rexes, so one of them were left off.
Tiny black thing.
I know.
Yeah.
Wonder
if the
tiny black
thing. You want to see, sweetheart?
Yeah, that's a llama.
Go lamp from anxiety.
Yeah.
Oh, it's showing all the different like cabins and stuff. What does she call it?
The lemurs.
Instead of a lemur?
Yeah, the lemurs.
The lemur.
Lemur.
Mr. Crow.
You can go ahead and pull it out.
What's the smell?
Not good.
What is it?
Poop.
What'd you find?
No bag.
Oh. Don't climb it, okay? Daddy will lift you. On here. Good job, Joel.
It is actually. Good job.
Nice.
See?
Mommy,
it said that everything highlighted in teal
the head and the curve of the nail.
Mm-hmm. You see the color difference? From the curve to that part? So that's original from the dig where they found it. Yep. This part too, at the top of the hair, Joel. See that color difference? It said that one was original too.
That
hand is
original.
What?
No. Oh well.
God so deserved them. God told Noah to go and multiply and fill the earth. Noah's family flourished and multiplied, and they did not spread all over the earth. Instead, they moved down from the mountains of Ararat and settled in the plain of Shinar and dreamed of building a great city.
Do you remember where the...
Come, let us...
Do you remember where Mount Ararat is? Do you remember where Mount Ararat is?
Yeah.
Where?
Not be scattered over the face of the whole earth.
No, but where is it?
God, the creator of the heavens and the earth, looked down upon them and saw the city and the tower they were building.
Henry Brody.
Yeah.
This daddy said those were y'all. Don't stand on that.
That one's me.
Brody.
Wait. There's a baby triceratops baby down there, and I would have it her up.
Get down, please. My brother-in-law, my sister's husband, told us about this place called Skyline Chili, and we had never heard of it before. And we got it last night for dinner, and it was really good. And we're getting it again tonight for dinner. It's right around the corner from where we're staying, and it's delicious. And we're exhausted and starving, so this is what we're getting before we head back. So, yeah.
Take bites of your hot dogs.
Alright, and there's that for
you.
Awesome. Everything looking good so far?
Yeah.
Alright, thank you.
Y'all like it?
Yeah. Okay, let's test the three-way.
Got a mountain.
Spaghetti, chili, and cheese.
Who wants to go first?
Me!
What do you think? Good?
Good.
Okay, bro, you ready? Good? That's two wins.
If you enjoyed us going to the Creation Museum,
check out our next video where we visit the Ark.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Collie Kids Adventures.
Hit that bell icon so you can get notifications to new videos.
Thanks for watching.